See, today we are taken up doer and enjoyer. This is the topic which when Mrs. Moni and Vasudeva asked me, I said doer and enjoyer, that is the karta and bhokta. So I will be taking on this subject, I said. So with this, we will go straight dive into the subject. So with this session, what we'll do is we'll explore the terms like what is karta, that is the doer, and what is bhokta, that is the enjoyer. So also we'll see, do we have any option not to become doer or not to become enjoyer? So, or we have any, why we have to do also the doership or enjoyership, why we have to do that also we'll look into. And what is the next step of doership and enjoyership, that is the akarta and abhokta, how to reach there? And also what is the phalam, we call it as at the end of that, so we call it as phalam. That phalam after becoming akarta abhokta, what is the phalam? So that we will be seeing. So normally we, as a human being, there is a proverb, there is a Subhashita, it says, Prayojanam anuddishya mandopi na karya nivartate. It says, if we don't have any benefit, even the dullest person on the earth will not attempt for any of the work. Any of the job, any, he doesn't want to work. That means whenever we are doing any activity, so there should be some prayojana that should be there. That was the Subhashita, it says that. When we see why we are doers, so that let us see why we have become doers. And is it possible for us to sit or keep quiet without doing anything? For that Krishna says in Gita, nahi kaschit kshanam api jatu tishtatya karma krutu karyate havashas karma sarva prakriti jair gunaihi. So Krishna's opinion, and Krishna says there is no one person on the earth or this one, it is not possible to remain without action even for a second. So that is what he says. Even for a second, no person can be possible to sit. So indeed, all beings are compelled to the act of their qualities of born material nature. That means each person, we are made up of material and consciousness. So the material has got trigunas, that sattvika, rajasika and tamasika, according to our predominant gunas. So we have to act, we will be acting, we cannot sit idle. It is not at all possible. So Krishna clarifies that. So you cannot sit idle, you cannot become, now you cannot say, I cannot become a doer, I will not become an enjoyer. So he says, in order to not to become doer and not to become enjoyer, so it is not easy task, but it is possible at the end of the sadhana. You have to do, you can become akarta and abhokta only after getting the jnana of that. So otherwise, each one of us has to become karta and bhokta. I will use the term for the doer and enjoyer. I will use the term karta and bhokta. That will be more easier for me. So you understand karta means doer and bhokta means enjoyer. Privilege of doer and enjoyership is only available for only human beings. It is not available for animals, because animals does not have any kartrutva. So when animals does not have any kartrutva, there is no karma also, and there is no karma phala also, because animals, they don't have any free will. Only human beings has got the free will. He can decide to do or not to do. So all those things, possibilities, and he has got the free will, then only he can do the act. Animals also doing basically instinctive acts. So what are those instinctive acts are called as four instincts: ahara, nidra, bhaya, maithuna. These four acts are done by the animals. It is only a basic instinct. They don't have any special willpower either to do something else apart from this one. Whatever preloaded program is there. Whereas for us, a preloaded program also is there, and also there is a choice of our own programming also we can do. Whereas for animals, it is all fully preloaded. Whatever a lion is doing today, it is also doing even 100 years, 1000 years, even 10,000 years before also the lion is doing the same thing. And even a honey bee is doing the same thing 10,000 years back also, today also, the same way only it is constructing its house and it is living and it is all this one. So it has not changed. Whereas a human being, so every generation, every 10 years, he will be doing a new thing. So the old style of living he discard and become the new style of living, and his intelligence is there, he is going to do that. So that is the difference between animal. Animal cannot become karta or bhokta. Animal has got only basic instincts, and a human being has got the special power of becoming karta and bhokta, and he has the willpower. With that willpower, he can acquire jnana also, and then that we will come to the next stages of. So Krishna, though he says it is difficult, so we have to examine whether why it is difficult, and also we have to understand why it is difficult. So our Vedanta, all the topics, it revolves under six topics mainly. Majorly in Vedanta, wherever you go, from Upanishads to and any other book or any of the Vedanta book, so it talks about Jiva, it talks about Jagat and Ishvara, Bandha, Moksha and Sadhanani. So these are all the six subjects only it will be dealt in all the Vedanta books. Maybe one book may be dealing only Jiva, or maybe Jagat, or maybe Ishvara, or all the six subjects also may be dealt in any of the Vedanta books. This Jiva is, we are the Jiva, and Jagat, what all the Prapancha we are seeing, and Ishvara, we have a belief of the consciousness, and Bandha means we have an attachment towards this Prapancha. And how to get this attachment, get out of the attachment and then liberate ourselves is called moksha. In order to get out of bandhana and getting moksha, as it is not possible. We have to get into the sadhana. So all the sadhanas are disciplines, and sadhanas are done through karma and jnana. So first we have to do the karma also, and jnana we have to acquire. Then only we can do sadhana, and finally we can achieve our moksha. This is how the scriptures are dealing always. So now if we come to the jiva, the karta, we are now concentrating more on karta. The bhokta is the resultant of that. So first we'll understand karta. Bhokta understanding will be next easier. Let's get into the karta portion. Karta, if we see, we are the jiva. As per the Vedanta, we have been called as jiva, and we are living in this jagat. So we as a human being, maximum 120 years, 116 years in scriptures they say, and maybe today 127 years also people are living. It is immaterial, but according to this one, 120 years we will take and see that. So during that 120 years of our living, so from birth to the death, we are living in three states, that is Jagrat Avastha, Sapna Avastha and Sushupti Avastha. everyone is bound to be either staying in one of the three avastha only. So now the question of dual shape, where it is coming? In swapna avastha, are we doing any dual shape? There is an imaginary person, there is a dream person is coming and he may be doing an act of all the things. And sushupti, the jiva itself is not knowing what it is doing. So jiva under deep sleep, it is there. So for our more understanding, the sapna avastha or sushupti avastha, we cannot do much of the work. So that means though we exist in three states, only in jagrat avastha we are becoming doership. Only in the jagrat avastha we are becoming karta. In other two avastha, most of the time we are not in the control of these two avasthas. In the dream state, whatever happened in the jagrat avastha in this life or in the previous lives, whatever happened, that only is playing. It is not, it is a VCP, we can call it as a video cassette player. It is only playing a video of already happened, already in this janma or in the previous janma, or some of the imaginations what you are doing in this jagrat avastha, that also may come in that dream state. So it is in the dream state our activity is only seeing the VCP, already recorded player, so that only plays. In the jagrat avastha, it is only VCR, there is no playing will happen. It is most of the time it is memory, storing the memory and getting information and getting into the recording mode only it happens. In the jagrat avastha, we are only doing the recording. In the dream avastha, we are only playing the recording. Recorded, either audio, video, everything, we will be doing it. In the jagrat avastha only, we can do any work and then only we will be called as karta. So we work in this jagrat avastha with the three karanas. Trikarana, we can call it as trikarana. So what all our working instruments are called kaya, vacha, manasa, body, mind and speech. So these three things only we are doing. So this is called kaya, vacha, manasa. So a karta will be doing the work in three karanas. If you see this kaya, vacha and manasa, kaya is possible to see by outside people. Not only me, and external people also can see. So vacha means by whatever we are doing, talking. So that becomes also a kayaka. So kaya, vacha, manasa. Kaya and vacha can be seen from outside people also. Whereas manasa, whatever the work is doing, the mind is either calculating or comparing or doing the planning of the activity and all those things, whatever the manasa does, it is invisible. And also manasa does some self-talk also it does. So it analyzes, it compares, it judgment does and everything. So it is not possible to see by outside. We mainly do in jagrat avastha in three karanas and also in the only one avastha we will be doing all the work. In that stage only we become either enjoyer or the doer. So either karta or bhokta, only here it is possible. Nowhere else we can do that. So that is the first understanding we should become, how we have become karta. If we have understood, can we stop this doing of this karta activity, either the doership activity or the enjoyership activity? Is it possible to stop? Can we stop physical activity? Can we stop mental activity? Can we stop speaking activity? It is difficult. Krishna says it is difficult. Then the question comes, why it is so much compelled to us? Why we have become a doer? What pushes us to into action? So that is also a thing will come to our mind. what pushes into action, or why we are compelled to become a doer. So for that, our scriptures say it is our desire. The current Janma desire is there. So whatever we wish or whatever is there, that is one thing is pushing us into becoming a karta or bhokta. Another one is we have fear. So fear also pushes either to do the job or not to do the job. Also vasanas, not only from this birth, in the previous birth, whatever the vasanas are there, due to the vasanas also we are compelled to do, become a doer or the karta. So that is one set of three things are desire, fear and vasanas. And the next, this one is likes and dislikes also push us into action. So what else can push us into action? So the feeling of inadequacy, feeling of shortage also pushes into action. Because I have inadequate, I want to make it adequate, or I have shortage, I have to make it fulfilling the shortage. Because of that also, I will be working on that. So other way why we work is, we are feeling imbalanced or left out in the society. In order to coming up in the race, then also I will be working for that. So another way why we work is, in order to become special in the society, in order to become a different person than the other people. So I want to always become a special person. I want to be a different person. So because of that also, I am compelled to do this action. It is not program. It is my own thought process are pushing me to become an action. So feeling to get noticed also, we will be working on to this one. So that is how we jump into becoming a doer. So daily, morning to evening, we are doing continuously a karta job or a doership, as well as the enjoyership will be done. Some of the karta jobs, whatever the doership when we are doing, the results may be immediate, or results may be little deferred for a month or a tomorrow or some years. Or sometimes some of the results may come even in the next birth also. So next janmas also it can come. So maybe like a curry leaves or a coriander leaves, within 1 month the result will come. Whereas something else will mango or coconut and all will come more than 10 to 15 years. So like that, each fruitfulness or the in order to become an enjoyer, immediately he may not get the fruit. Some fruits are getting immediately after he become the doer, immediately he will get. But doer will be doing immediately many activities, but the fruit will come immediately or stagnated over years or over the next births also it can become. So how our mind is tuned is, in order to become karta, so we will be either desiring, in the above I have told you, no, what all the reasons we are compelled to do the work. So that reason becomes an ichcha in our mind. Ichcha is a desire will be planted in our mind. So then what happens, our mind will search for the knowledge how to fulfill that ichcha. So it is called ichcha, and then jnana, we will be getting it. And then we are jumping into action, kriya. We are getting ichcha and jnana and kriya. With these three roots only, we become a karta, and we also become a enjoyer also. So, for example, I want to construct a house. The desire will come in me. I want a house. After that, I select which place I have to do, what is the size, what is the amount, what is the budget, what is the design and everything. Up to that, I was not knowing at all. What is a house also, I don't know. I may be living in a rented house, or I am not even not knowing. Somebody may be rented, I am staying with them. The moment I desire, already my mind puts me into the Jnanarjana. So what type of house, what is the size, what is the layout, what is the cost, everything, automatically it gains the knowledge. And then once it is prepared, then the Kriya, the Karta will be jumping into action and getting finished into, making it to finish. So this is the routine. This is how the root of Karta is happening. So at least at this three roots you have to find and you have to keep it in mind. Karta and Bhokta is simultaneously happens. What is Karta actually doing? We have to find now. What he does? See, we say Karta means is a desire is there. A desire is running towards an object or a thing or an idea or anything like that. Or running away is also a Karta only. It is not that only running towards is not called Karta. It is running away is also a Karta. So the meaning is both doing only. Running away is also doing, running going towards also it is doing. Both are in the same line. So that is why we are maybe in the same axis only we are performing it. We are not going into the third axis or other axis. So what happens? It is just plus or minus. It is not a new thing we are doing. If I like a jamun, I eat it. If I don't like a jamun, I dislike it. And if somebody is telling you have to eat jamun, I will be pushing away from that. I don't want to be eating that. So that is the way I am also doing. In order to push away from that also, I have to do a lot of activity. Also automatically, once desire has come, it cannot subdue. So you have to push away. So pushing away the desire also, you have to do a lot of activity. In both the time, you become a Karta. So what happens? Literally meaning, we are in the same line only, either from the right side of the axis or from the left side of the axis, we may be there. While we are going to get, we are going maybe towards right, if I say. So while you don't want to get rid of that, so we will be going towards left in the same line. So we are not going in any other direction. So that means doing and doing or not doing, doing or escaping, doing or running away. Everything is Karta only. And the problem of Karta, what happens? The idea of an object. For example, now I am telling, I like a girl. So I want to get her. I want to get married to her. So what happens? My mind is occupied with that girl. So all other activities goes behind the screen. And this is becoming more prominent one. Until I get this girl, I will be struggling to get that girl and get married and all. So tomorrow I want to get rid of that girl. Again, I will be struggling a lot of things. And though I get rid of that girl, till I am getting rid of the girl, the thought process is always happening on the girl only. We are not doing any other activity. This is one of the activity. I may be doing a lot of other activity. Now I am talking about the girl liking and now disliking when I do that. But the thought is occupied that only, and all the action related to that thought is only I becoming again a Karta and again the Bhokta for that it will become. So what happens? The Karta and Bhokta is a cycle. So when Karta is getting happy, his efficiency looks to be improved. When Karta becomes unhappy, his efficiency looks to be deteriorated. So this is what every day we are getting in our life. Sometimes we are happy, we are efficient. Sometimes we are unhappy because we are unhappy. And then only we become inefficient. So efficiency and inefficiency mainly depends on the Karta and Bhokta. Suppose now I have did a job and because of that, the result is not happy. So who is getting affected? The unhappiness is the bhokta, the same person only. When I am doing a job, I have become a karta. The result when it has come, so if it is a happy result, bhokta also happy. Bhokta is not disturbing. That means my personality is not getting disturbed. So my efficiency is continuously going on. So everything happy, 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 and continuously improving my efficiency may happen. Suppose whatever the result is not happy for me, at that point of time, bhokta is suffering because karta is not suffering. Karta has already done the job. Bhokta is suffering. That suffering person also I am only. Doing person also I am only. When the bhokta is suffering, whatever the next step of the karta, any new job he want to do, this bhokta is affecting the karta. So it is a cycle like, so karta is doing good, bhokta also, result also is good, bhokta is also happy, and he will support the karta for the new job also. So like that his efficiency goes. Like bhokta getting affected, all the thing will get affected the next karta. So every minute we become a next karta and a next bhokta. The next karta is getting affected. Next karta, when it's getting affected, his efficiency comes down. He does, his efficiency comes down, the result also comes down. Again, the bhokta will get affected. So we become into the vicious circle like this. So both are happening because of the likes and dislikes, and running away, running towards that only is happening. So that means my likes and dislikes continuously pulling me in both the sides. Sometimes happy sides, sometimes in the unhappy side. And I'll be an efficient karta or an inefficient karta, or an efficient bhokta and an inefficient bhokta. So like that, what happens? I will be pulled both the sides. So as long as this pulling both side is there, we cannot always be happy. The happiness and the sadness is always there together. Joy and sorrow is always together it comes. So then we will be put into our duality mode. So always sometime happy, sometime unhappy. So we will be saying that it is the two sides of the same coin only. Happiness and unhappiness is the two sides of the same coin. We will give a slogan and then we will accept in that way, and only we don't want to come out, we don't know how to come out of that. The vicious circle will be pulling us deep into the center, and our moods will be swinging left and right, and we cannot enjoy any relationship, and already whatever we have achieved also we cannot enjoy. So that is what happening. This is called our unhappiness cycle. Our happiness cycle, this is called, we call it as in Sanskrit, samsara tapatraya. Samsara means not only husband and wife is not the samsara. Whatever I have created, the karta bhokta cycle is there. That is samsara. And from that tapatraya is always happy, unhappy things, everything is coming. So we cannot get out of that unless we learn new jnana, new sadhana, then only we are able to come out of that. Otherwise, this is the continuous thing only will happen. And there is never ending. And also, we should note that we always have a notion that if we have a desire, if we fulfill, then my desire is fulfilled and I will be happy. But whatever we have desired 10 years back, we already got it. Whatever we got 40 years back, we already got it. Most of us, everything we got it, whatever we wanted 10 years, 20 years, 30 years back. But why are we not happy? After getting, we should be happy, no? We are not happy. So actually Vedanta says, so satisfying a desire cannot make you happy always. Satisfying one desire, so it will sprout another 10 desires. So now from one karta, you have become 10 karta, and you don't have, you have only 24 hours. You don't have more time. This 24 hours, you are becoming multiple kartas and multiple enjoy shape. So most of the time, the efficiency of the multiple karta comes down. And then also, when efficiency comes down, results also will come down. So because of that, we are into the vicious circle of happiness and unhappiness. So this is the importance of the karta and bhokta. So what is the solution? So what Vedanta says, what is the solution? It says, don't run. That means things will come to you, but don't run. So when you are running, you may be forgetting what is coming, you may be not knowing at all. So don't run. So that is what it says. Stand and observe the play of opposites. So that is what it says. So if you want to explain that, so all the people in the other Vedanta scriptures, like Astika Darshana and Nastika Darshana, all our Astika Darshanas are Vedantas. So their likes and dislikes, Krishna or Vedanta, whatever it says is, it is Asakti and Nirasakti, both are together. So Asakti and Nirasakti are together. If you are in the same cycle, it is not possible. So you have to go to the next one, is called as Anasakti. So that Anasakti, you have to go. So whereas Zen philosophy also says, like, attraction and repulsion is there. So attraction and repulsion is the regular activity of a mind. It will get attracted and repelled. But we have to go to Nirakarshana. Zen, it says as Nirakarshana, it says as. And Buddha also says, see, he says for and against. Buddha's language is for and against. Paksha, vipaksha, he says. But Buddha says, paksha, vipaksha, in this cycle, if you are there, you cannot be happy. So you have to become indifferent. For, against, instead of that, you become indifferent. It is called upeksha in Sanskrit. So you should not be paksha or vipaksha. You should become upeksha. That is what Buddha says. Even Mahavira also says, he says raga and viraga. So wherever the raga and viraga is there and we are embedded in that, you are not becoming happy. Then you have to go to a next step of vitaraga, he says that. Almost all the word is same only. Anasakti, nirakarshana, upeksha, vitaraga. All those things are same meaning related only. But what it says in the nutshell is, we have to understand the choicelessness is freedom. That is called, it says, vitaraga, and all it says is, finally, you have a lot of choices. So the choices when you make, you become karta. So choicelessly things are available. So you can be, so at that point of time, even the results also is not embedded in that. So in order to get the freedom, Buddha says, choicelessness is the freedom. So you have to get into that choicelessness mode. That is a sadhana, it says. But how to go to this choicelessness stage is the third dimension. That is what in the many of the people have been told. Even Ashtavakra is one of the rishi. He is talking to Janaka. He is giving the same thing in a different fashion. Ashtavakra says to Janaka, though Janaka himself already a learned man, he is already a Rajarushi, he has understood Vedanta, in spite of it, he has lot of clarification was wanted. So Ashtavakra was advising Janaka, we are already, every one of us are tuned only to see two things only. So that is likes or dislikes, like that, whatever is there. But the knowledge is required to understand and see the third direction. It is the non-dual dimension. But we are already wedded to this or that. Without that, we don't know at all. Hot or cold, long or short, big or small. Like this only, our dictionary is filled with only the dual of the things. The pair of opposites, we think it is opposite words. But pair of opposites, literally in our dictionary, it may be opposites. But our mind attracts to both. Opposites also attracts. So in a different way, even a repulsion is also an attraction. Buddha says repulsion is also an attraction. It grips the mind. If you like also, you have to spend time. Your mind has to work on the liking. If you dislike also, your mind has to work on that. That means your mind is gripped. That means your attraction or repulsion, both are hindrance only. So that is what it says. So he says you have to become non-polar. Anasakta is a non-polar attitude you have to come. When he becomes anasakta, what happens? He says that. So he, when he becomes, Ashtavakra says, when you become anasakta, so his attitude becomes indifference. So what happens? He will not do judgment. So he accepts as it is. It looks to us very difficult to understand and digest this. But all the Jnana Marga taught is only this. How not to do judgment. How to accept as it is. So that means in the Jnana Marga, it is called as becoming a witness. How to become a witness? Again, the question will come. For example, we are happy always whenever we are not doing any judgment. Example, we go to a seashore, we are seeing the sunset, and sunset, we don't make any judgment, like a mountain, tree, flower, this mountain should have been like this, it should have been not like that, this tree would have been like this, this should have not been like that, this flower should have been like this. All these things like this, not like this is my judgment. My dictionary is filled with my own knowledge. It is not the true knowledge. The true knowledge only you have to learn. That is what all the scriptures say that. What is the true knowledge? So the true knowledge is going towards truth. So the what all the truth? Truth is there. For example, we have a water bubble. The moment I say there is a bubble in the water, the bubble is already got burst. So that means the bubble was there. Yes, it was there. Where is now? It is not there. So it is there, very, very temporary truth. So that is the first level of truth is called as Pratibhasika Satya. So the second level of truth is the wave is there in the water. Yes, wave is there. It is coming from a long, from the long distance to the seashore. So I can see the same wave and it comes to the shore and it diminishes, it goes off. So that means it has got longer time than the bubble. So that is little bit more time is there. That is called as Vyavaharika Satya. So Pratibhasika Satya is very immediate and temporary truth. It is not a permanent truth. Water bubble was there, I can say. Water bubble is there, I cannot say. Wave also, maybe 10 minutes I can say wave is there. On the same wave that he is surfing, all those things I can say. But the wave also get diminished. So that means that is also a little bit longer it lived. So that is the Vyavaharika Satya. The third level of Satya is called as Paramarthika Satya. So we have to get into knowing into the Paramarthika Satya. Paramarthika Satya is eternal. It will not change with the time and space coordinate. It is always eternal. So the Paramarthika Satya is understanding this temporary Satya is also a Paramarthika Satya. This temporary Satya, we don't understand. And we argue on this temporary satya. If two people are talking and arguing, If you see that everything on temporary satya only arguing, none of them they are going into the truth of that. Suppose if I say in this match cricket century has been scored by Sachin Tendulkar, so other man says no, it is not. So whether it is century spoken or whatever is there, only for it, that match only is useful. After that, it becomes a history, and both of us, we are fighting. So in every activity of our daily life, we are fighting whether this is right or that is right. My right is for my right, and your right is your right. So we are fighting on that, and we are becoming unhappy and happy because of all those things. What is paramarthika satya? That is the only way it happens. For example, we have to accept that is a temporary truth. It is a pratibhasika satya and it is a vyavaharika satya. We have to accept. That acceptance is not so easy. Suppose I have born and we undergo for 6 vikaras, shad vikaras. Asti, jayate, vardate, parinamate, apakshiyate, and vinashyati. The 6 stages we go. That means we will be getting established in the womb and then coming out jayate, vardate, we are growing, and we apakshiyate, we come to a praudavaste. That is, after that we start deteriorating, apakshiyate, and vinashyate is getting destroyed. So we know that these are all the 6 stages are there and we are seeing everything. But when somebody is dying, we feel, I am not going to die. That is not, I am not going to accept, it is not coming into my mind only. So I live like always I am living, and I will be always young. No, not possible. So these are all the things what forcibly we are accepting. So heartily when we start accepting, then what happens? That is the paramarthika satya. That is the way only it works. Nature works like that only. So all the leaves will fall off once in a summer and new leaves will come. That is the truth. Whenever I want, a new leaf cannot come. So like that, most of the things are paramarthika satya, accepting that, the truth as it is. It is not a new truth. The truth is not permanent. You should not think as a permanent. It is as it is temporary. And then everybody understands that are surrounding me. If I start understanding, I will not get into arguments. And I will not become most of the time karta because of unwanted things. My karta-ness, instead of 100 karta, I become only 10 karta all of a sudden by understanding these 3 truths. Going towards the truth is very important. That is what all the scripture says. So you have to accept as it is. As it is the truth. So immediately you become instantaneously happy when you start accepting. So you may not be commenting, somebody else may be commenting, but the compulsion, I want to oppose that comment and I want to prove my point, is my compulsion. My compulsion is I am also not accepting, because whatever he is telling, either he is for that he is telling also, I am not accepting. If he is telling anything against of that also, I am not accepting. I want to show my individuality. I go into the temporary truths. All the temporary truths, fighting and making it permanent is my mind thought processes are there. Because of that only, samsara tapatraya comes, all our unhappiness comes. Otherwise, just like eating, sleeping and all will not give any of the big problems. Like animals also do and we also do. But most of the time, my belief system is getting affected because of our other person's belief system. The fight starts from there. And then only all my mind works for finding the logic, making this one enmity. And everything you will get by one and get one. Like that it will happen. When you have become angry, you are bought already headache, stomach pain, acidity, everything. Buy one, get 3 free. So all because you become angry, you got other 3 things free of cost. It is free of cost means you have to understand. It is ironically I am telling that. So this is what our package. So when we are doing karta, we should be very, very careful. When we are carefully, when we are thinking and doing and acting, we become an efficient karta. The efficient karta is not impulsive. He will be very, very thoroughly understanding, and the acting also is not immediate. So he does very, very careful actions. Thereby, his kartaship, instead of 100 karta, he becomes daily. I may be going every minute new karta, I can become. Becoming new karta becomes lot of tension, lot of energy is lost. And everything is a wasteful energy. Even if I win the argument of that, it's a wasteful energy. And energy, when it is depleted, if I lose, I will get hatredness. If I win, I will get ego. So both are dangerous. The hatredness will, the jealous will make me acidity. My health will get upset. So many damages inside may happen. Relationship damage may happen. Finances may damage happen. Even in the organization, my power, my position, everything may go because of this bad karta. So we have to understand how to calm down my this thing. So this is mainly due to the ajnana. So what is the ajnana? We want to do judgment unwantedly, and we don't want to accept as is. This is my hindrance only. There is nothing, external hindrance is not there. It is my own hindrance is there. Because of that, I am not able to enjoy my life. So it is ajnana. It says, all the Vedanta says you have to know this ajnana and how to come out of this ajnana. You have to work for that, it says. So whether this is possible, it is only a story, it says. So there are so many people are there even now amidst us. They are all very, very calm and quiet. They are not getting perturbed. And they are, most of the time, they have already decided this is what it happens, this is how it will be. So my effort, their effort they are putting, they are not becoming fatalistic. They are not stopping to work. But their reactions they are bringing down. They are only making efficient action. They are not making reactions. So they are giving a proper responses. The responses makes me better karta. And when I become better karta, the results also will be better. And immediately you become a better bhokta also. So better bhokta may not be a much this one. Better bhokta is a wise bhokta. So better karta means, if he thinks everything is in my control, nothing is in my control, because whatever I can do, if a job has to be done, I always say, give a coffee example. Suppose I want to do a good coffee, I have become a good coffee karta. If I say that, whether everything is in my hand of making a good coffee, not there. For example, I need a good milk. A thick milk should be there. It is not in my hand. It comes, though you bring a this one on that day, your packet may not be there. Instead of blue, in green, you may get a red, or red instead of red, you may get a green. So maybe there. So every time you cannot predict whatever you want to do. The coffee powder should be good. You wanted a particular brand every day, you may not get the same brand. Even if the same brand, the quality may be varying. Or it may be old, everything may be there. Also, your mood also makes a good coffee. Whether on that day you have a good mood or not, you don't know. Even the drinker mood also makes a coffee good or not good. Because the coffee, though you have done good, the result is not the coffee. Whoever drinks the coffee, he has to say good. Your husband or wife should say good. Then only you feel the cycle is completed of the karta. So even then you are not having control. So if you see morning to evening, coffee powder has to be grown in Chikmagalur or somewhere. The good seed has to be taken. It has to be dried and then it has to be made powder, roasted. with proper amount of chicory according to your taste has to come to your table, and then you have to boil the milk, boil on that day, gas should be there. If all those things are there, so many things are there to make one coffee the best coffee. That means then only you become a best karta. So it is only a coffee example I have given in life. It is not coffee only you have to look. Most of our activities, most of the things what we face in life is also, I can do my job very efficiently, but many of the other things are involved by other people also. Other factors are there. So many other uncontrollable factors are there. It is not in my hand. So what is my problem is, first as a karta, I will decide I will be doing this, and it is not possible because of uncontrollable factors. Immediately the karta himself will become depressed and leave alone bhokta. The karta himself is depressed and his next action will get affected because he becomes an inefficient karta already. So the bhokta continuously becomes inefficient also. So he cannot enjoy. So we have to earn karta bhokta, because accepting this, everything is not in my hand. Whatever is, I can put my thing, I can do. Rest of the thing, I have to wait. I have to do. So this is, I may be thinking, I can go to the shop, I can buy the same dress. So this is not a thing. So you may build a house, but you may get cheated by the contractor. Or you may get some material, it may get cheated, or it may not be of your required quality or taste or something like that. So everywhere, if you are becoming disgusted, when are we going to enjoy the life? So I have to become an efficient karta, means I have to accept the paramarthika satya as is. Vyavaharika satya, it should be like this, it is not like that. Temporary satyas also, it should be there, it is there like that only for a temporary period. So we have to see, then my mind will be ready to become a better bhokta. So that is what it says. So becoming a better karta is a karma yogi. So when you become a karma yogi, we become a, most of the work will become akarma. Akarma means akarta. I will become a, most of the work I will be doing as an inaction, I will be doing an action. So I will become an inaction. So what happens in order to become an inaction, action in inaction, inaction in action. So I will come to that. So in order to do that, we have to learn some sadhana. So that is, in order to reach to become a perfect karta, I have to have some steps. The first step is sadhana. So there are a lot of sadhanas have been told in the scriptures. That sadhana separately we have to deal with. And the last step is siddhi. What is the siddhi? So he is already in a position to accept as is. When you become as is, acceptance comes. It is not that you should not put action, this one planning, you should not do this one achieving. That is not, nobody says that. Whenever you do, everything will not happen to according to your will and wish. So whether you are prepared for that, if you are not prepared for that, the sadhanas will help. And siddhi means when you are already accepting that without grumbling, everybody accepts that. Without grumbling, without damaging the nearby relationship, either money or health or whatever the atmosphere, everything without damaging, if I am able to accept that, that is siddhi. So in that siddhi, continuously when you do, so most of my actions itself will come down. I am getting to accept as it is things. So for that sadhana, it says is, you have to make your mind gati, bringing it down. Yogascha chitta vritti nirodha. So why, what is yoga is telling that it is also a sadhana. So your mind gati, manas gati has to become slow. So that means agati. So when agati, when it comes, it becomes akriya also it becomes. So what happens when we do more and more activity in the mind? Mind becomes hot. When mind becomes hot, even a computer becomes hot, it becomes radical. So in order to cool the mind, we have to go to Upasana Yoga, and then that is all sadhana steps. I am just telling, but details we have to go in there only and see that. And cool the mind. When the cool the mind, then your thought process, your computer, brain, everything will work better. And then you will come to a better karta state. That is what it says. So we have to get into mind swinging. We have to bring it down. So when mind swinging comes down, becomes a still mind, then it becomes a balanced mind. A balanced mind is just like a balancing doll is there. Suppose in our earlier movie and all, the doll will be moving like this and this, if I say that. So what it says is, balancing doll, even if you try to push to the ground that doll, it will come back and stands. So that means my mind, even somebody externally makes into like that, it will come back. So that comebacking is only with one thing of sadhana, is accepting as it is. It is accepting the paramarthika satya. So that is, everything has a some rhythm is there. So that rhythm will come whenever it need to come, at that point time only will come. That is the paramarthika satya. For my urgency, nothing can happen. So when I am able to understand that, peace of mind will comes in like a balancing doll, and he overcomes, he conquers the struggle of a bad karta, becoming a bad karta. He becomes an efficient karta. And whenever you become an efficient karta, slowly what happens? My feeling of inadequacy will come down. Because when you are accepting, it slowly comes, and you will be coming, the inadequacy is called as apurnatvam. And when you are understanding that, the paramarthika satya, so you understand that I am already from the beginning only, I am Purana. I need not become again by Purana, by complementing something externally. I am myself already from Purana, it is there. That is the jnana. And that is ajnana will convert into jnana. Ajnani to jnani he will be converting. So when he converts, there is nothing was lacking for him. He feels that. So as his acceptance immediately removes that lackingness, immediately he becomes a jnani, attains samatvam. Samatvam is equanimity. There is no extremes he will not be going. He will be like a balancing doll. Immediately he comes back. So normally the jnani also may get upset, but he comes back within 5 minutes, within a second he will come back. If on the this one, somebody may take more time to come back, somebody may take years to come back. So where are we now? We have to analyze. So our frequency has to come down. The frequency of getting upset has to come down. I have come to samatvam. So Shankara says, sarvam paravasham dukkham, sarvam atmavasham sukham. It's simple sentence. But every time I am depending on the external thing. So that external thing dependency, when you make self-reliance, that self-reliance is accepting as it is. That is the first step. This anasakti is, that is the thing. Asakti, the moment when you make asakti, there is always a nirasakti also. I may get attracted, I may get repelled also. The same thing, today I like jamun, tomorrow after five times, ten times eating, I may not like jamun also. So asakti is always backed with an irasakti. It comes just like a cycle, it just like a circle. Once you reach one point in the circle will get completed. There is half is negative, half is positive. If you say it is a continuous cycle, will be happening. So if you are externally dependent, we cannot avoid. So the external dependency is not on the material or anything that. My attachment on that, the knowledge. So if my knowledge improves that, I will not get attached to that, saying that this is the truth, this is the permanent truth, this is as it is truth. So when I start accepting as it is truth, sarvam paravasham becomes sarvam atmavasham. Everything is in my control, it becomes. When everything becomes in my control, it becomes sarvam atmavasham sukham. So that is what it says. Action in inaction and inaction in action. That only one sentence I will complete and say that. For example, I'll give you three examples. One is, I am standing on the shore, so of the ocean. A boat started from me and it is going away from me. When it is going to a long distance near to the horizon, it looks like boat is not moving. Though boat is moving fast at that place, if you go and see, boat is moving fast in the water. But now I am seeing there is no action is happening to the boat. The boat is looks to be standstill. A jnani will be like, imagination, you keep it. Another one I will say, there is actually, there was a motion in the boat, but I am seeing is there is no motion. Because there is a time and distance, time and space. So the time and space are the foreground and the background. So a jnani will not see without foreground and without background. He sees as is. So that is, so I have given you one boat example. I will give another example, you see that. So there is in a cloudy day or a windy day, what happens? The moon is moving fastly. Actually, moon relatively is not moving. Maybe 24 hours once he may go around and all, that is a different thing. But moon is not moving relatively compared to the cloud. But moon is constant. But we look, moon is moving. So that is another example. You have to keep it. So another thing I will give an example is, say I sit in a railway station, I'm sitting in my seat. The next train adjacent to me moves. So what happens? My train is moving, I am moving, that is the thing will come. So if you analyze these three things, action in inaction and inaction in action, can be understood in a very beautiful manner. So you please spend your time and understand. So with this, I am going to conclude. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha. सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ओम् श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम् सो थैंक यू ऑल थैंक यू फॉर मेडिटेशन एंड स्टडी सर्कल एंड थैंक यू फॉर वाणी एंड वासु एंड थैंक यू फॉर ऑल द वेदांत लवर्स